bills in the by-election. As Jeff Hutchison reports, Cleary doesn't quite fit the mould of a soberly suited politician. And as for making big speeches, well, he prefers to save his best for three-quarter time in the match of the day.
This afternoon at 4 p.m, I received the resignation from the House of Representatives of the Honourable R.J.L. Hawke as the member for Wills.
When it was announced that Bob Hawke was going on the political pension, the people of Coburg, a working class community in Melbourne's northern suburbs, knew their lives were about to be turned upside down.
I think when Bob Hawke first got in, he was a genuine bloke, okay? But everyone's the same. They give you a bit of power, he's in there for a long time. He got corrupted like the rest of them.
News of an all-important by-election, one which would bring Keating and Hewson to town to kiss babies and bond intimately with the locals, only made those locals shiver, pull up their blue collars, and believe not a word. Recession and unemployment had cut deeply in Coburg. What was once the heart of a thriving textiles industry now had an unemployment rate of around 20%. Twice the national average. Coburgers were, naturally enough, suspicious of strangers bearing gifts. But in this time of desperate need, who could they turn to for inspiration?
We are going to be physical. We're going to be cooperative. That is, we're going to team together. We'll sacrifice ourselves for the sake of a loose ball.
The football coach, that's who they turn to, Phil Cleary, a man born and bred here, who bled here, and who over 18 years had died at least 1,000 deaths for the glory of the Coburg Footy Club.
I've always been into the idea that you really ought to argue things through, and that authority shouldn't be taken for granted. I suppose I had a bit of a rebellious streak in me. Maybe it's the Irish, I'm not sure.
Oh, they call me Phil Cleary.
Cleary's kick is well directed, I think. It's another goal to Coburg.
It just happened out of the blue. You know, it was just, the circumstances were right. Hawke resigned, I was there, someone rang up, it got in the media, then lots of phone calls, and before I knew it, I was in there.
A vote for an independent like Phil Cleary is a wasted vote, and it could cost you your job.
I'm sure that the people were really wanting to make a firm statement. They were saying, look, we actually count. We can make a fair income decision about our lives, and we're going to do it. And it was more than a protest, because the electorate was saying that, well, right, we're protesting about what's gone on, but we're also telling you that we can think, that we know things, that we care about certain things, and they are important to our lives.
Sensitive to his community's needs, Cleary had a profound advantage over his opponents, and it was reflected on polling day.
He was claiming victory as the first non-Labour candidate to win the federal electorate of Wills since it was created 43 years ago.
I mean, people can come up to me at the football and talk to me about politics. They can even run a policy by me, you know. So it's not as if I'll be removed from people, and that was part of our campaign too, the idea that I had to be accessible.
Well, Phil Cleary's great. I mean, he was a great footballer. He gave all for Coburg, and only without Phil Cleary, there wouldn't have been at Coburg. I've seen all the great coaches from Nichols, Duncan's. I've seen them all, you know. Phil's as good as any we've ever had, like, you know. He knows the game, and he's so determined and so fair dinkum, and we all knew he'd win as a politician, because the opposition he had wasn't very much anyway, like, you know.
The Mutimers and their friends have been standing on these terraces since 1945, watching the local boys defend sacred turf. The VFA competition, the oldest in Australia, still plays the game as it used to be played, and Dot and Jack are grateful to people like Phil Cleary for preserving it.
Now, you don't just give up the game.
Come on.
I mean, really, fellas, you can do better than that.
Come on.
They hang on to his every word, trusting his sincerity, his commitment, and his ability to inspire. Political qualities Bob Hawke once noticed on a visit to the change rooms.
Start being creative and
And just at some stage he leaned over and he said, Phil, he said, the way you spoke to the boys before the game, you know, we should be looking at you for pre-selection for one of our seats.
Footballers venturing into politics is nothing new. Indeed, the Tasmanian Premier Ray Groom was once a star.